See, the next objective is to introduce a systematic scheme by which we can formalize elementary row operations. Okay. Towards that, I will discuss a notion of elementary matrices and some of their properties. You will see that in the next lecture, this will culminate in a complete theoretical understanding of the solutions of a system of linear equations, homogeneous or otherwise. But before that, I will make a quick review of matrix multiplication. I suppose all of you know what matrix multiplication is, how it is to be done. I will make a very quick review and then move on to the topic of today's discussion, okay, discussing the so called elementary matrices and where do they come in this discussion on elementary row operations, okay. So matrix multiplication is what I would like to discuss first very quickly. Let us say I have two real matrices A and B, I have two matrices, let me give these orders like this. A is R m cross n, B is R l cross p, okay, these are given to us, then the product is defined. The product AB is defined only if n equal to L, okay. And in this case, if you call the product as C, C equal to AB, this matrix is of order m cross p, okay, this all of us are aware of, I am sure. This is a rather peculiar way of multiplying two objects, okay. What I would like to do is to write down the formula for the ijth entry of the product, that is what we will need today. If Cij is ijth entry of C, then what is the formula for Cij? Is there a volunteer? The formula for Cij? See, I am asking you not the determinant, I am asking you the ijth entry of the product. Summation k equals 1 to what? Okay, this is how the product is defined. That is if you write down the matrices fully, then you will know that the ijth entry of the product is the dot product of two vectors, dot product of the ith row of A and the jth column of B, dot product of the ith row of A and the jth column of B, that is Cij, okay. Okay, now this is, you can take this as a definition of the product. Then what can be verified, I am going to leave this as an exercise for you, what can be verified is that the product is associative whenever it is defined, okay, that is if AB and BC are defined, then AB into C is A into BC, okay. Product is associative, matrix product is associative. It is also distributive over addition, that is if you have A into B plus C, if this is defined, then this will be equal to AB plus AC, okay, product is distributive over addition. The product is peculiar, I mentioned. Let me give you one or two instances of its peculiarity. It's quite possible that the product AB is defined, but BA is not defined. You can construct simple examples to show that the product AB is defined but BA is not defined. Even if AB and BA are defined, they could be of different orders. For example, you take A 2 by 3, B 3 by 2, then AB is 2 by 2, BA is 3 by 3. They could be of different orders. Even if the orders are the same, AB is in general different from BA. AB is in general different from BA, even if the orders are the same. Okay, you can give an example for each of these for each of these illustrations. Finally, it could also happen that AB is the zero matrix. It could happen that the product is 0 without either of the factors being 0. Okay. It could happen that the product of two matrices is 0 without any of the factors being equal to 0. Okay, you must have studied in algebra 0 divisors. Okay. Product, there are 0 divisors. If you look at the binary operation as the product of matrices, then there are 0 divisors. That is, there are matrices A and B such that A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0, but the product AB is 0. Okay. So, I have listed some of the peculiarities of matrix multiplication. I think this is enough for me. I will move on to the topic of today's discussion, that is the concept of elementary matrices. Using the concept of elementary matrices, I am going to further formalize the elementary row operations and then bring about a systematic scheme of analyzing systems of linear equations. Okay, what is an elementary matrix? It is a square matrix. An m by m real matrix is called an elementary matrix. If it can be obtained, okay, it's a square matrix. If it can be obtained from the M by M identity matrix, I start with the M by M identity matrix and then do a single elementary row operation. If it can be obtained from the M by M identity matrix upon a single elementary row operation, okay. Take the M by M identity matrix, do a single elementary row operation on it, the resulting matrix will be called an elementary matrix. Okay. Let me list all the 2 by 2 elementary matrices. Okay. You will see that there are only 5 possibilities. See, remember this is upon a single elementary row operation, not a sequence. Okay. Example, the set of all 2 by 2 elementary matrices. I want to write down all these. There are 5 in number. Okay. You will see that these are the only 5. Okay. I'll move on here. 0, 1, 1, 0. Interchange of the 2 rows of the identity matrix. Take the first row, that is 1, 0, alpha 0, 0, 1, multiplying a row by a non-zero constant, multiplying the first row by a non-zero constant. Similarly, multiplying the second row by a non-zero constant. Okay, 3 possibilities. Replace a row by a constant times another row plus the row that I started with. Yes, I have replaced the first row by first row plus alpha times the second row. A similar operation for the second row. The first row remains as it is, second row will be alpha 1. So these are all the elementary matrices of order 2, precisely 5 of them, okay, in number. Okay. Elementary matrices have a special property that they are invertible. Okay. So before I discuss this particular property of an elementary matrix, let me go to the notion of inverse of a matrix. Okay, maybe I should do something else before that. What is the effect of elementary matrix has been obtained by a single elementary row operation on the identity matrix? Okay, how is this related to an elementary row operation being performed on a single matrix A? Let me first discuss that. I want to discuss the following. This is the importance of introducing an elementary matrix. Take an elementary row operation, perform this elementary row operation on the matrix A. Okay, I am given a matrix A and an elementary row operation. I perform this elementary row operation on the matrix A. The effect of this, the resultant matrix, which is row equivalent to A, is the same as pre-multiplying the elementary matrix corresponding to this elementary operation by A. Is that clear? E, capital E equals small e of y means that I am doing this elementary row operation on the identity matrix of order m. I get an elementary matrix, I am calling that as E. Pre-multiply this matrix E with A, then I get another matrix. This matrix is the same as performing the particular elementary row operation E on the matrix A. Okay. So element performing elementary row operations is effectively pre-multiplying the matrix A by elementary matrices. This is an important observation. Okay. Let us first prove this and then look at the consequences. Again, out of the 3 operations, I will discuss only 1 operation. The other 2 are simple. So I will discuss the case when you replace a row by a row plus a constant times another row, and show that this formula holds in that case. The other 2 you could treat them as exercises. So I need to prove this. Okay, is that clear what this theorem says? Pre-multiplying, for example, this could be used in a program. Matrix multiplication is easily done by computers. So one could apply, one could think of a sequence of elementary row operations as multiplying the matrix, pre-multiplying the matrix A by a sequence of elementary matrices. Okay, so let us see how the proof goes. Okay, I will move in here for the proof. Okay, so I have two matrices, one on the left, one on the right. I need to show that these two coincide. I will show that the corresponding entries coincide. Two matrices are equal if their corresponding entries are the same. I will show that, so this is the claim then, claim to show that EAIJ, ijth entry of EA is the same as small e of A, ijth entry. Then it would follow that these two matrices are the same. Okay, for this I need the formula for the product and also what capital E is. What is capital E? Capital E is, see, for me E is, for me E is the operation replace row S by row S plus alpha times row T. This is my operation. Okay, E corresponds to this operation. I will prove this result for this case. The other two are similar, simpler. So I want to write down the matrix E. I will write E I K because that is what I will need here. I want the formula for E I K. Just tell me if this formula is correct. For I not equal to S, say I am doing this particular elementary row operation on the identity matrix. So take the identity matrix, look at the Sth row, replace Sth row by Sth row plus alpha times Tth row. All other entries are left as they are. So if I is not equal to S, it is the same as the entries of the identity matrix. For the identity matrix, there is a special notation, the Kronecker delta notation, delta ij. Delta ij, this is equal to 1 if I is equal to j, 0 if I is not equal to j. I am looking at the entries other than the Sth row. So can you see that this is eik, so that is delta ik. When I is not equal to S, it is the same entry as the identity matrix that I started with. That entry is delta ik. If I is equal to S, what is the formula? Sth row delta sk plus alpha times delta tk, is that no, there is yeah, this is fine. Eik is this. Okay, so I will use this definition of Eik and then use the definition of matrix multiplication and then see what this left hand side is. It will turn out to be what you have on the right hand side. So let us do matrix multiplication to verify this equality. So I want the ijth entry of EA. Okay, that is, I am writing down the formula, summation k equals 1 to m. See, capital E has, is of order m cross m. Remember, this must be a square matrix and in order to pre-multiply with A, the order of E must be m by m. A is m cross n. K equal to 1 to m, eik akj, this is the formula for the product, the ijth entry of the product. Now since eik has the split formula, I will write like this, summation k equals 1 to m, for I not, sorry, for I equals s, summation k equal to 1 to m, I will have to substitute this formula, delta sk plus alpha times delta Tk into Akj. If I is equal to S, it is summation k equals 1 to m delta ik Akj if I is not equal to S. I have just substituted the formula for capital Eik. The ikth entry of capital E. Expand and simplify. This is summation k equals 1 to m delta Sk Akj plus alpha delta Tk Akj if I is equal to S. And look at this now. This is delta Ik Akj. K is a running index. K is the running index. I and j have been fixed. Ith row, jth column. Entry is what I am trying to calculate. I and j are fixed. K is a running index. K takes the value 1 to m. I varies between 1 and m. So when k takes the value I, this will be 1. All other entries are 0. Okay. So remember that k is our summation running index. I and j are fixed. So when k equals I, so this has only one term that corresponds to k equals I. When k equals I, it is delta ii aij I not equal to S. Okay, let's complete the bracket here. Okay, a similar thing we need to apply for the first part. So let me give that here. For the first part, it is summation k equals 1 to m. I'll right away simplify. Delta Sk Akj. K is a running index. When k takes a value S, it is 1. All the other terms are 0 corresponding to the first term. So when k takes the value S, it is delta SS. So the first term here reduces to delta SS ASJ plus the second term. When k takes a value T, it is 1. All the other terms are 0. Alpha times k takes a value T, delta TT ATJ. This is when I is equal to S and delta II is 1. So this is Aij if I is not equal to S. I hope this is clear. This simplifies to delta SS is 1, Asj plus delta TTT, TT is 1, alpha ATJ. This when I is equal to S, it is Aij when I is not equal to S. But you see that this is precisely the definition of E of A, where E is this operation. The S throw is replaced by S throw plus alpha times a T throw. All the other entries are the same. So this is the ijth entry of E of A. Okay. So these two matrices are the same. So performing an elementary row operation on a matrix has the same effect as pre-multiplying the given matrix by a particular elementary matrix. This elementary matrix is obtained from the identity matrix by applying this particular elementary row operation on the identity matrix, single elementary row operation. Okay. So what does this tell you about row equivalent matrices? Okay, that's what we'll see next. What we'll see is the following. Given two matrices A and B, what we would like to show is that then B is row equivalent to A. You will see that this is a consequence of the previous theorem. B is row equivalent to A if and only if B equals P times A, where this time P is not a single matrix, it is a sequence. Okay. So this P is a product, by which I mean a finite product, where P is a product of elementary matrices. P is a product of elementary matrices. If I do a single elementary row operation and get B from A, then this P will be an elementary matrix, otherwise it is a product of a finite product of elementary matrices. Okay. Now you will see that this this will be useful later also. There are certain things that are preserved by elementary row operations. In the case of a square matrix, for instance, we will look at certain numbers, the determinant, the rank, the inverse, etc. One could calculate the inverse, we will show, by using elementary row operations. We will show that certain numbers like the determinant, the rank will remain the same if A and B are row equivalent. Okay. In proving those results, we will make use of this, that B can be written as P times A, where P is a product of elementary matrices. Okay. Now there are two parts, okay, for this result. So let us take the first one. Suppose B is P times A, I must show that B is row equivalent to A. Okay. Suppose B is P times A, where P is, what I am given is that P is a product of elementary matrices. So let me write like this, ES, ES minus 1, etc., E2, E1. B is equal to P times A, where P is a product of elementary matrices. We would like to show that B is row equivalent to A. Okay. Okay. What do we have? B is P times A. Use the formula for P. ES, ES minus 1, etc., E2, E1, A. So let me introduce a bracket here. Matrix multiplication is associative. So I can write this as ES, ES minus 1, etc., E2 times E1A. Matrix multiplication associative, that is what I have used here. Now look at E1A. E1A, by virtue of the previous theorem, is row equivalent to A, because E1 is an elementary matrix, and so it is an elementary row operation being performed on the, a single elementary operation being performed on the identity matrix. By the previous theorem, E1A is row equivalent to A. Okay. E1 is row equivalent to A. Then the next step, you push E2. Again consider B equals P times A, ES, ES minus 1, etc., E3, E2, E1A. E2, E1A is row equivalent to E1A by the previous theorem. Row equivalence is an equivalence relation, in particular transitive, it is row equivalent to A. So I have E2, E1A row equivalent to A. Okay. Being row equivalent to A, this is the first step, this is the second step. Proceed by induction. Proceeding similarly. What follows is that ES, ES minus 1, etc., E2, E1, A is row equivalent to A. Taking one elementary matrix at a time. But this left hand side, ES, ES minus and etc., that is precisely B. So B is row equivalent to A. If B is P times A, where P is a product of elementary matrices, then we have shown that B is rho equivalent to A. I hope it's clear. We must prove the converse. Is the first part clear? Conversely, suppose that B is rho equivalent to A. Then B is obtained from A by a sequence of elementary row operations. B is obtained from A by a sequence of elementary row operations. I will call it E1, E2, etcetera, EL minus 1, EL. That is, I am doing first E1 on A, then E2 on E1A, etcetera. That is, that is the first operation, E2 on E1A, etcetera, EL, EL minus 1. Here again, I am making use of the fact that every elementary row operation corresponds to pre multiplying the matrix A by an elementary matrix. Okay. An elementary row operation on A has the same effect as pre multiplying the matrix A by an elementary matrix. That is why I get this sequence E1, E2, etcetera, EL. Okay, so first operation is E1, I do E1 on A, so that is pre multiplying A by E1. Second is E2, pre multiplying E2, pre multiplying E1A by E2, etcetera. So this sequence is EL, EL minus 1, E2, E1A. I can write this as, this whole thing I will call it as P or Q. So I have B equals QA, and Q is a product of elementary matrices. Q is EL, EL minus 1, etcetera, E2, E1, which is a product of elementary matrices. That is the second part. Okay, so the important step to observe is that an elementary row operation on A is equivalent to pre multiplying the matrix A by an elementary matrix, and I am taking this sequence of elementary matrices. Okay. Let us now move on to the invertibility properties of elementary matrices. So I need the notion of the inverse of a matrix. Okay, let me give the definition. Some of you might be aware of it. I have an n cross n square matrix with real entries. Then this matrix A is said to have a right inverse, if there exists another matrix B of the same order as A, such that right inverse. Okay, so I have AB equals I, identity is the identity matrix of order n. I on the right is the identity matrix of order n. Okay, if if there is a B that satisfies this equation, then A is said to have a right inverse. A left inverse is defined similarly. If there exists a matrix C such that CA equals I, then A is said to have a left inverse. Okay. Together, if A is said to be invertible, if A has a right inverse and a left inverse. A is said to be invertible if A has a right inverse as well as a left inverse. What we will first show is that if A has a right inverse and a left inverse, then these two coincide. Okay. A has a left inverse and a right inverse, then they must be the same. So let us prove this. This is easy. Let us write down the definition. There exists B such that AB equals I. That is, I am considering B. Since A has a right inverse, there exists a B that must satisfy this equation. There exists C such that CA equals I. So now start with B. B can be written as identity times B. Identity is the identity matrix, is the identity operation of matrix multiplication for square matrices. Identity times B. Now for this I will borrow this equation. This is CA times B. This is matrix multiplication is associative, C times AB. But AB is identity from that equation, so this is C times identity, that is C. Okay. So I have made use of both the equations to conclude that if it has a right inverse and a left inverse, then they must coincide. Let me also prove two more properties of invertible matrices. If two matrices are invertible, then their product is also invertible, and a formula for the product can be given immediately. The inverse of the product is the product of the inverses taken in the reverse order. Okay. I am going to leave this as an exercise. It is easy to verify. Just look at the defining equations for the inverse of a matrix. For a single matrix, what must be true is that you do the inverse operation twice, you get back the original matrix. A inverse inverse is A, okay, if A is invertible. Okay. And the first property can be extended. The first property I can also say that a finite product of invertible matrices is invertible. A finite product of invertible matrices is invertible. These are easy exercises. Okay, what is important more to what we are discussing is that every elementary matrix is invertible. Okay, every elementary matrix is invertible. Every elementary matrix is invertible. Okay, that's what we'll prove. Do you have a choice for the inverse of an elementary matrix E? I want you to make a guess of E prime. E prime will be the inverse of E. Yeah, what is, okay, we are using prime for that. Okay, so let us define capital E prime as E prime of I. E prime is a notation that I used for the inverse of E. That, so let me complete where E prime is the inverse of the operation E. E prime is the inverse of E. So when I am given E, I know E prime explicitly. In fact, I have written down those three formulas for E prime. So I know E prime explicitly. So the claim is that this E prime satisfies E into E prime equals I, E prime into E equals I. So it is both a left inverse and a right inverse. And so capital E is invertible, that is every elementary matrix is invertible. The proof uses composition of functions and the fact that E prime is the inverse of E. So proof, proof is already there. I have to just verify this. So consider E times E prime. I want to show that this is equal to identity. E into E prime is what? This is pre-multiplying the matrix E prime by the matrix E. E is an elementary matrix, so this corresponds to an elementary row operation. So this is E of E prime. Do you agree? Pre-multiplying the matrix E prime by E is performing the elementary row operation little e on capital E prime. This is E of E prime, definition is E prime of I, small e prime of I. Okay, this is composition of functions. This is E circle E prime operating on I. Okay, but E prime is the inverse of E. So E circle E prime is the identity function. I will call it I of I. Identity function on I leaves it as it is. So I have E into E prime is the identity matrix. Identity operation on I. I get back I. E prime E can be worked out similarly. Okay, let me do that also quickly. Consider E prime E. This is pre-multiplying the matrix capital E by E prime, that is performing the elementary row operation small e prime on the matrix E, which is performing E prime on E, the definition is E of I. Okay, this is again composition. This is E prime circle E operating on identity as before. This is the identity matrix. Okay, so what we have shown is that E prime is a right inverse as well as a left inverse. So capital E is invertible, that is each elementary matrix is invertible. a little exercise for you at this stage. Find the inverses of all the 5 elementary matrices of order 2. I had written down the elementary matrices of order 2, all the 5 elementary matrices I had written down. Find the inverses of all these operations. You only need to find the inverses of the elementary row operations. Okay. What we would like to do next is in the next lecture is to discuss properties of elementary matrices, invertibility, connection to systems of equations. Okay. I'll just give the result that I would like to start with from the next on the next class. Next class, I want to prove this theorem. For a square matrix A, for A in R n cross n, the following conditions are equivalent. Okay, this gives a connection between row equivalence, elementary matrices, invertible matrices. Condition A, A is invertible. Condition B, A is row equivalent to identity. Condition 2, A is row equivalent to the identity matrix of order n. Condition C, A is a product of elementary matrices. Okay, that is A is invertible if and only if A is row equivalent to I, if and only if A is a product of elementary matrices. Okay. In proving this, I would make use of a little result which I will ask you now. The question I will ask you, you try to come up with an answer tomorrow. Suppose I have a row reduced echelon matrix, a square row reduced echelon matrix which is invertible. I have a square row reduced echelon matrix which is invertible. What can I say about that matrix? Capital R is a row reduced echelon matrix, it is square, it is invertible. What is R? R is equal to identity. Try to prove this. We will make use of this result next time. I will stop here.